classes. This is class 5 and you are having your science e-learning class. Okay. And as we are doing the third chapter, safety and the first aid, and we came to know lots of rules about the safety, how we can become safe by following those rules and how we can prevent from any kind of accident. So if we are little bit careful and not become the so careless, then we can avoid the accidents. But even if any kind of accident happens, if any kind of problem arises in our life, that time how to tackle those type of accidents and what are the prevention measures we have to take, and how we have to treat the person, the immediate treatment before the doctor's arrival. So we know what is it called, the immediate treatment before the doctor's arrival. Whatever the treatment we are giving to that patient for any kind of accident, that prevention or this kind of treatment, this kind of little bit caring things, doing so that the thing become not so worse, this type of treatment is called first aid. So we have learned about what we have to do if the bone has been fractured. In that case, we can use the sling or the any kind of sling we can use, and as well as we can use the splint. So splint is a tight thing or a wooden surface or any hard surface on which we can just tie the fractured bone, so it will become very strong and that portion of our body cannot move so frequently. And the sling is just to, if our any kind of fracture happened in our hand, that time sling is a triangular piece of cloth, and on that we can keep our hand, and so that our hand will do the minimum movement. Okay, so this is the preventive things, and these are the measures we have to take before the doctor's arrival or before the doctor's treatment. Now we came to know there are three kinds of the burns. One is a burning. Burning are three kinds. Maybe it is a very minor burning. So in that case, we have to wash this burning part in a running water, and then we can apply any kind of any kind of lotion or any kind of just wash the thing, and then we can apply antiseptic lotion or antiseptic cream, so that this kind of not become so worse, and it will cure within 1 and 2 days. And if the burn is major, then what we have to do, it will see the blisters are there. We have to be careful that we don't have to prick that blister, we don't have to break that blisters, because blisters is a type of mechanism which our body produces to protect that wounded area. Okay, so it has to be dry automatically after a few days, when the inner skin will recover and the inner skin will replace, inner burned skin will replace by the new skin. Okay, but somehow if the blister has been broken, if the blister we pick somehow, little kids, they can pick the blister, that in that case we have to wash that area and we have to bandage that area using some antiseptic cream. Okay, so these part which are burnt from this this burnt area will become safe from the other kind of viruses or bacteria. Otherwise, any other kind of disease, any other kind of infection may be within for the patient. So we have to be careful about these things. Next one is that if the person is being burnt from any chemical, that time we have to be very careful. We have to wash that burnt area thoroughly with cold water, because this burning sensation is very corrosive in nature, or you can say acid, and these chemicals are usually corrosive in nature. Corrosive means they give a burning sensation. Okay, so to prevent this type of sensation, at first we have to wash this area with cold water, so it will become cool and it will become we will not have that much painful sensation or the burning sensation, and then we have to rush towards the doctor. Now another two kinds of injuries are given here. First one is dog bite. So the saliva of the dog, saliva of the animals like dog, cat and monkey contain virus or very dangerous disease called rabies. So saliva of the dog, monkey, mongoose, these type of animals are having a kind of insect, or you can say a kind of virus called rabies. They are inside them. When a dog or a street dog is biting you, along with the saliva in that open portion, these viruses transmit in our body, and it is very dangerous because we will become diseased by this rabies. So if any kind of this kind of animal, maybe monkey, maybe dog, maybe mongoose, maybe rat, any one of them is biting you, you have to rush to the doctor and you have to take the treatment. There are some antivenom against this rabies, and they will put you some injections, or they will suggest you few injections, so that you will become safe from this kind of disease. Okay. So we have completed this one. Now there are three actions are given. There are three things are given which we have to do. First one is wash the bitten part with soap and water to wash away germs. So at first we have to wash that area where the dog has been bitten, or where it has been bitten by some animal. So in case of dog bite, we have to just wash that area so the germs can be washed with the water and soap. Now apply an antiseptic cream on the affected area to prevent infection. If we will not apply any antiseptic cream, so maybe other kind of germs, other kind of viruses and bacteria can attack on that portion, and the condition will become more worse. So in this case, we have to wash the area with the cold plain water along with the soap, and then so that these germs will become washed up. And then we have to apply one antiseptic cream or antiseptic lotion. Now take the victim to the doctors immediately. Doctors may give anti-rabies injection. It is very necessary step. If a person is bitten by some dog or some any kind of animal like monkey, so they are having the rabies, we have to immediately go to the doctor so the doctor can give the injections or the anti-rabies injection that will save your life as well, that will save the disease. Okay. So it is very necessary condition. Now the next one is a snake bite. We know when a poisonous snake such as cobra, and we have read a lot in the EBS these all, but even then if the cobra, crab or any poisonous snake is biting, so the amount of their poison is different, as well as their whatever they are biting, they are having the two fangs in front, or you can say the front teeth, which are very poisonous. They are actually hollow teeth, and within this teeth the poison is there. When a person is bitten by some dangerous snake or a poisonous snake like the cobra or crate or Russell viper, that means they are making two holes inside your body along with the help of their fangs, and they are pouring their poison inside the skin. And this poison goes inside of the skin and they spread along with the along with the flow of blood. So it spread very easily. It can spread inside of our body. So the blood affects the heart or the other organs. But once this poison goes to our heart and reaches to our heart, the heart becomes stopped to pump. So what we have to do? Immediately we have to take few of the precautions. So what is the precautions? First one is apply a tight bandage just above the portion where the snake has been bitten. So what it will do? It will stop the flow of the blood, so that along with the blood, the poison will not reach to the heart so fast. It will become slow down. The flow of the blood will become slow down. So the poison will spread. Spreading of the poison will take some more time, and it will go very slowly. So that is the first thing. What is the first step? First step is to tie a very tight bandage over the place where the snakes has been bitten. Okay, so that the flow of the blood will become minimized, or you can say it will become slow, and it will the first prevention. Next one is take the victim to the doctors immediately, and doctors give you the anti-venom injection. And as I told you, it is better to identify the snake, because according to the different kind of snakes, there are different kinds of antivenom injections which give to the patient according to the amount of the this poison and according to the type of the poison. So it is better if you come to know about the snake, it will be better. Okay, so at first find out and you see here and there, maybe the after giving the poison, the snakes will become very lethargic and they cannot move so fast. So maybe they did not across a place, or maybe they are within some place they have been bitten. So we have to find it and we have to inform the doctor accordingly. But first move, you have to tie the bandage or tie a very a cloth piece or a towel, anything very tightly just above the place where the snake has been bitten. Next one is, last one is poisoning. Things like detergents, naphthalene ball and insect killers are the poison. Such things should be kept out of the reach of the children. If the naphthalene ball, the insect repellents and anything is just lying on the floor or they are within the reach of the children, so they don't know about the consequences, what could be happening to them. So they may eat them, they may lick them, because babies have a tendency to lick the things, no? Sometimes the small children also do the same. They lick the things, they eat the things, whatever they find. So if they lick or they just eat these things or they just slowly just follow the thing inside their stomach, it may be poisonous for them and it may be fatal. So we have to be keep all the precautions in our mind and we have to take all the safety rules and we have to take all the preventions as well as we have to follow all the safety rules so that we will be protected from any kind of disease or any kind of this type of accidents. And we should also be very careful when we are dealing with the electrical appliances, when we are dealing with the poisonous things, or whenever we are in the playground or somewhere in the bus, we have to always be alert. Okay, when you are alert, then you will never meddle. So this is a proverb, but it is a very very fact, or you can say it is a truth which has been spoken in this way, that when you will become careful, you will not get any kind of accident. But still, if any kind of accidents occur, you have to take the precautions, you have to take the, you have to give some first aid measures and then you have to go to the doctor. So that's all for today. In my next video, we will discuss about the questions of this chapter. Okay, till then, bye bye, take care of yourself and always be careful.